In this video, we will work with probability distributions and also use StatCrunch to determine the mean and the standard deviation. So I'm working on a problem from the homework in the ebook for section 5.1. And in this section, it says determine whether it is a probability distribution, and if it is, find the mean and the standard deviation. If a probability distribution is not given, identify the requirements that are not satisfied. So this is working with male color blindness. When conducting research on color blindness in males, a researcher forms a random groups with 5 males in each group. The random variable X is the number of males in the group who have a form of color blindness. And here's the distribution right here. And if you remember, the requirements for a probability distribution are 3. There is a numerical random variable X, and its number values are associated with corresponding probabilities. So in this case, we do have a random variable X with values from 0 to 5, and each of those has a probability associated with it. The sum of all the probabilities equals 1. And let's go back and notice it also says that rounding may come into play here. So let's go ahead and add these up and see what we get. So 0.659 plus 0.287 plus 0.05 plus 0.004 plus 0.001, and we come up with 1.001, which according to the definition is all right because it has to do with some rounding. So that's it. We met criteria 2. And every probability for each individual value of the random variable X must be between 0 and 1. And we see that that's true from the table. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to calculate the mean and the standard deviation for this probability distribution. And I'm going to use StatCrunch. And if you remember, the way we use StatCrunch is we go to our MyStatLab course and we click on StatCrunch. And then we click on go to the website. And then we click right up here on Open StatCrunch. And I've already opened it up, and I'm going to show you what I did. I went ahead and I put in the X values in the first column and the probabilities associated with those in the second column. So if you compare that to the data in the table that I just showed you, you'll see that that's exactly the same data. So let's just pull this over here so you can take a look at that and see. So I just went ahead and I put the X values in this column, and I put the probabilities in this column here. Now, quite easy. Rather than using the formulas given in the book, what we're going to do is we're going to go to Stat, we're going to go to Calculator and Custom. And the first thing is, where are the X values for the random variable X? And those are in the column that I labeled X. And the weights, which are the probabilities, are in the column which I labeled P of X. And then we just hit Compute. And we'll see here, here's our mean. And if we round off here, remember, one more decimal place than the original random value variable value, so it's going to be 0.4, and the standard deviation is going to be 0.6. And this, I think, will make your calculations in section 5.1 much easier than trying to use the formulas in the book.